Hey guys, so today I'm going to be filming a video on my favorite YA contemporaries, and if you're new to that term, YA means young adult, and it's basically like a whole cool book genre for teenagers. So yeah, I love books. I just got so into books, and all I've been watching are booktubers, and it's pretty cool the videos that they make, and I kind of want to join in that community. So this is gonna be like the start of a ton of new book videos. For now, I'm just going to be talking about and showing you guys my recommendations and my favorite young adult contemporary novels. So yeah, let's just get started on the video. Okay, so I'm going to be starting out with my favorite young adult novel of all time. And okay, you know what? I'm not even going to be able to convey how much I love this book and how profoundly this book impacted me, because like words like can't even describe how much I love this book. So this is the book. It is Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe. And this, guys, this book was such a quick read for me. Like the title seems very like academic and like a long, difficult read, but it's not at all. I finished this book so quickly and I was bawling on the plane, you guys. Like, I read this on the plane because I just went to New York. Like, it was a 20-day vacation. It was so long. And on the plane ride back, I was reading this book and I was just bawling my eyes out. Like, I couldn't stop crying. Like, I was just crying so hard. Like, every line in the book literally made me cry. Just, like, the book was so profound. It was so beautiful. And, like, it was just one of the most beautifully written books I've ever read, and I love it so much. I just want to read the sequel. I love the diversity in this book. I think the YA contemporary genre needs more diversity. Like, the two main characters are both Mexican, and it's LGBTQ. So LGBTQ romances are actually my favorite romances to read about. I'm just gonna quickly put that out there. You don't need to know anything about this book. The only thing you need to know is that it's phenomenal, and I can't imagine anyone not liking it, and it's covered in awards, and it deserves every single award it has. The next book I'm going to be talking about is Sarah Dessen's book. It is This Lullaby, and I think Sarah Dessen is a perfect gateway author to kind of get into when you're first getting into the contemporary romance young adult genre. This was the first, like, kind of young adult book that I read. I just recommend her as a whole. This was the first book I read by her, which is why I'm going to include it in this video. It's This Lullaby, and Sarah Dessen is just known for writing kind of like the same plot line throughout her books but with different characters, and for me it does not get repetitive at all, because each story is so different in personality and drama and everything like that. But I really enjoyed this book, so yeah, I'm gonna include it. The next book is one of my most recent reads, and it's Anna and the French Kiss. And this book just made me so freaking happy. Like, something about it just made me very, very happy. And I think if a book can do that, it is worth so much. And this book just made me so incredibly happy. I thought it was a beautifully written book, and it was just the perfect read for me at the time. And I loved all the characters. I feel like I kind of related to Anna, but there were times when I was just like, okay girl, like, you're low-key selfish, because like, she just kept on thinking about Etienne, and like, there were problems, like, bigger problems than her romance, and like, she just, I don't know. But it was a phenomenal book. This put me in all my feels. I love the main character. Etienne is so thoughtful and so charming, and I'm assuming he's really cute, so I mean, he's just a mix of like, Parisian and like, English and American, and I just thought he was so thoughtful. I love this book so much, and I highly recommend this to everyone, and this might be like the cutest contemporary of all time. The next book I'm going to be talking about, and this video is already so long, is I'll Give You the Sun by Jandy Nelson, and this is a very, 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 very good book. Now, it's not really it's contemporary, but there are like bits of magic in the book, and sometimes I was confused because I wouldn't know if it was something actually happening or it was just how the author was writing, because there are a lot of lines in the book that sound like it's magic but you're not sure if it's actually happening or if it's the way the author's writing, which I did not think that was a problem at all, because I loved this book so much. It kept me so entertained, and I was tearing up towards the end of the book because there are some really heavy topics in this book, and it was sad at times, and maybe it's just because a lot of the sad moments were related to a parent, and I'm like so close with my parents, so like it really hit me hard. So like I was crying for parts of the book, but I thought it was an amazing book. You'll never be bored. I just thought it was a phenomenal book, and it put me in all of my feels. I loved the romance in this book. The next book I'm going to mention is The Hating Game. This is another recent purchase slash read of mine. I read this while I was on vacation, and I think this book is kind of teetering on the edge of adult because this book was like really steamy, you guys. Like, I was reading this and at times I was like, this is like a lot. I thought that the storyline was amazing. I felt so deeply in love with the two leads. It was such an incredible romance, and I definitely recommend this book. This book I'm going to talk about is The Selection, and I actually borrowed this in the Elite from the library. Yeah, it was a good book, and okay, the writing in this book is very, like, it's very, like, amateur, which isn't always a bad thing, but, like, for example, like, a line will be, like, I didn't want to enter the selection, period. But it's not like I had a choice, period. My mom told me to, period. But I didn't want to listen to her, period. Or maybe the author was just trying to, like, write it in, like, a teenager's dialogue since America is the narrator, America Singer, the main character. But yeah, I don't know. It was weird, but it was a really good book. Another good book is Since You've Been Gone. This is one of my favorite books of all time. I just got The Unexpected Everything in the mail, and this book is just about two best friends, Emily and Sloane. Sloane disappears. She's the bold and daring one, and Emily just has to go on, like this kind of adventure to find Sloane, but Emily is very shy, so throughout her tasks, she kind of breaks out of her shell and she meets friends, and it's just so well written and so entertaining, and I really, really, really liked this book. I hope I did a good job with like one of my first booktubing videos, but yeah, I hope you guys liked this video, and I'm gonna be posting a book haul very shortly, so yeah, I hope you guys liked the video.